So unlike Trump, who's managed to avoid any consequences despite being accused by at least 15 women, Bruce Alexander is in federal custody tonight facing a sexual assault charge. So I'm going to bring in now Sara Nelson. She's the international president of the Association of Flight Attendants. Sara, thank you so much. I really appreciate you joining us here.
Happy to be here, John.
What went through your mind when you heard Bruce Alexander's excuse?
Well, this is disheartening. It's totally disheartening for flight attendants. I will tell you that in the last couple of years, we've been taking on this issue of sexual assault and sexual harassment on our planes. We found in a survey of our members that passenger-on-passenger sexual assault happened 1 in 5 times that flight attendants had experienced that, and only half the time did law enforcement actually meet the flight. That survey was taken before the Me Too movement broke. After the Me Too movement broke, we started talking about sexual harassment against flight attendants and took another survey. And our members said that 68% of them had experienced sexual harassment or assault in their career. And 1 in 5 in the last 12 months had been physically assaulted, sexually assaulted by passengers. So we said to the industry, look, you cannot continue to allow us to work in a environment that was set up to be sexualized, where flight attendants were objectified, where they ran ads that said, I'm Cheryl, fly me, and or put us in hot pants and go-go boots, and really sold us to the traveling public. That was never denounced. So we called on the industry to do that. United Airlines CEO, Alaska Airlines CEO, Spirit Airlines CEO, stepped up as leaders and set a new tone for the culture to say there's zero tolerance for that.
Listen, and you should applaud the folks for doing that. But let me just get it straight, because you reeled off a number of things there. You said that that you talked about the types of incidents that happen on airplanes. But I'm wondering, I mean, have you noticed these types of incidents and other aggressive behavior happening more often on flights, either to passengers or to flight attendants?
When there is a culture of sexual misconduct, it happens because people think it's okay. And when you have the highest authority in the land leaving us hanging there with that excess Hollywood tape, with the other accusations, not just laughing it off or saying that it's something that happened in the past or saying that it didn't happen.
Or it's locker room banter.
There are not two sides to this story.
Yeah.
The only thing that should be said from the highest authority in this land is that it should never happen.
Okay, let me read your statement. Let me read your statement, because I think it's important. It goes into what you're saying now. And you released a statement on behalf of the Association of Flight Attendants saying, in part, when the highest authority in the country brags about sexual assault, it is virtually impossible to change a culture of sexual misconduct and contempt for enforcing the laws that should protect victims. Now, you don't mention the president by name, but it is clear who you mean, what you're talking about. Why did your organization decide to wade into this, Sara?
Well, we have been working very hard on this issue, and let me be clear, this is not a partisan issue. We just had an FAA bill passed that had some really significant items in it to address sexual misconduct on planes. And that was passed overwhelmingly bipartisan writing of this language by both House and Senate Republican and Democrat leadership, passed in the House by 398-23, in the Senate by 93-6. Ted Cruz didn't bother to vote. But this was overwhelming and bipartisan and supported that we need to address sexual misconduct on planes. So there's real leadership there, and it's going to take leadership to turn this around. And so this is an issue of leadership. And when the highest authority in the land, when the president is allowing this to go on, we are unsafe. He's leaving all of us hanging because he left those tapes hanging. He never said he was sorry. He never said it was wrong. He never said it shouldn't happen. And that is what has to be done in order to create a safe space for everyone.
So Bruce Alexander was charged today, Sara, with abusive sexual contact, could face up to 2 years in jail, $250,000 fine. What message do you want to send to anyone out there who thinks that they can do as they please to women on your airline?
Well, I'll tell you what. I want to applaud the flight attendants and the pilots on this plane, because the flight attendant said, not on my plane. And the pilot said, not on my watch. And we are wising up, and we're calling on all the public to join us. Law enforcement came too. Everyone did exactly what they should do to report, to support that victim who reported this issue, to get her away from him, and to move this to justice. And so that's what we're going to continue to do. That's what we're going to continue to call on all of the leadership of this country, both public and private, to say, is that we have zero tolerance for this in this country. This is a country that is not going to accept sexual harassment, sexual assault, sexual misconduct, or marginalization of women, period. And if the President of the United States can't say that, we're all going to take the responsibility to make sure that it happens.
Sara Nelson, thank you very much. I appreciate your time.
Thank you.
More on this next. The Dan.